Can't believe you're on the show. Thanks for coming on the show. Can't believe it. Can't believe it. Can't believe you're on the show. Greatest things in life are sex, football and rock and roll. Would you say?
Yeah. I should think so, yeah.
Okay, which is the best out of those?
Football.
Football.
It's the only thing I can't do, probably.
If you had to give up two, would you give the other two up and stay with the football, Rob?
No. I think I'd stick to singing then. I think I'd do that better than kicking the ball. Mind you, I have brought a little memento along for the... The eternal optimist here, I think.
So you're a big Wolves fan, aren't you?
Yeah.
Jimmy, you don't like football at all?
No.
But he's not.
I spent my youth playing the guitar.
Yeah? Yeah. We know, don't we? We know. And you became very, very good at it. So a lot of rockers, a lot of old rockers, right? Older rockers. No, it's true, though. You know, they've been around for a while. Did all the mad lifestyle, all the wild things. Then now they're all off the booze and they can't do anything, they drink water. But when you two arrived here today, Phil, who works on the show, he's a great guy, apparently... He snuck out some two really rare bottles of vodka, and you both went top show. Yes. So you two still enjoy it, don't you?
Yeah, but look at us.
But you seem happy enough.
Yeah, it's.
Have you ever had to give up the wild excesses for a while? Do you have to lay off for a couple of years before you did?
Well, when I go to sleep.
Yeah. So you're still full on, totally.
Oh, I don't know about that.
No, I don't think so.
They are. They're
it's
still full on, everyone.
It's a family show.
Okay, no, fair enough. Are you aware of what's going on the streets as far as you and Led Zeppelin are still concerned?
Well, something's amazing going on at the moment. I mean, everywhere we look, it's happening. In the last 10 days, we've been in Istanbul, New York, and back here. And everywhere we go, it's getting wild.
Does that surprise you, though?
Well, it's a bit of a shock, really, because we've been in the studio for ages recording. And when you get in that underground situation, you don't even think about what's going to happen when you put the record out. And we're just days away from release. It's like waiting to have the baby.
But you played a concert in London on Wednesday, and a lot of people that work with us went, and they said it's the... And they go to a lot of gigs, obviously. Mm. And they said it's the best gig they've ever been to. I mean, what's the reaction like from people who are watching you?
Well, I think what it is we're a four-piece again, aren't we?
Yeah.
You know, yeah. And... Before we were travelling with the Egyptians orchestra and all that sort of thing. Now, as a condensed four-piece band, we really do what we used to do really well, and we're doing it better.
And you don't mind playing
old men do it better.
Do they? Yeah. Well, I can't wait to get old.
They're not so sensitive in certain areas.
But you don't mind playing the old Zeppelin stuff, do you? Because a lot of bands shoe their old material. You love it still, don't you?
We haven't got much else to play, have we? We've only got one new record and that's it, you know. So.
But you went through a period in the 80s,
yeah.
Rob, where you cut all your hair off and you went into denial and now it's all back and beautiful and gorgeous again.
Yeah, I know. Well, I'm hiding a few creases now, see.
But you're content and you're happy to live with the memories and enjoy them again?
Oh, absolutely.
Okay. Now, we did a phone-in on the radio this morning and I've never, ever, I've been doing it for 16, 17 years, ever had a response. I can't believe I'm talking to you in the turban, but never mind. Or whatever it's called.
I know a lot of people who look like that.
We've never had a response like that. And a guy called Steve phoned up the radio show from Manchester, and he's over here now.
Yes.
And,
is that you?
Yeah.
Come here, let's have a look.
Steve, Tom. Okay. Steve, come here. Steve, come here. Sit down. You can sit down. Have my chair.
My head's gone too.
Okay, and Steve couldn't believe it. I said, why
I wish
you...
I had the hair. Jesus, I wish I had the hair.
You don't look like a Led Zeppelin fan or a...
Well, I am. I had my hair when I was 16 that long, but it's long gone.
Okay.
Hereditary problems.
Ask them a question, go on, because I know you want it.
Right, well...
Family show.
The one... maybe one question that you don't maybe want to hear, but for all Led Zeppelin fans, sort of, you've been bootlegged that much... why won't you release sort of the definitive live album, a box set like Springsteen did from 16, I know you've done the BBC sessions, but from like 69 to 79, because we've read about and we've seen and we've heard, you know, the best concerts ever.
So why?
You were the best.
Well, yeah, we got a lot of live tapes from 69 right through to like the last Nebworth one, which was like 1979, 80. But it's a question of time, really, you know.
Could it happen?
Well, maybe eventually.
Maybe,
who knows?
See? There's hope. Yeah.
There is hope.
That's the best thing you can do
years ago. I mean, I don't.
But I think we're playing better now than we did then.
Well, rock and that was awesome. That was awesome.
Okay, look, you've got other fans. You've got famous fans. Jeremy Clarkson's faxed us with a question. Ask Robert if it's true they once had to cancel a tour because of the hosepipe ban.
Is that true?
I don't know. What was the weather like at the time?
I don't know. Is it true?
I don't think so, no. That's a good one. Okay. I like that.
He's off his head. This one's off Dale Winton, who apparently was a massive fan. Dale Winton was a massive fan. He was DJing the clubs. And he said, here are two questions. We'll just ask one. As a club DJ in the 70s, an album track called Jamaica was a huge reggae hit on the dance floor. Why was it never released as a single?
Never put singles out,
never
really.
Never put singles out.
No. Well, they didn't play us anyway, so...
We're desperate. We're whoring ourselves like crazy now. I think we can have it as a follow-up.
OK, and this one's from Julian Lennon. Question from Julian for Robert Page and... sorry, I knew I'd say that, Jimmy Page. I knew I'd say that, Jimmy Page and Robert Plant. Will bet me a fiver. Will, you've got your fiver. Which pub are you going to tonight after the show?
I was going to go here to your bar.
Because the beers are free. The beers are on me. OK, right. Listen, of all the stories of Led Zepp, about what percentage are true, would you say?
In my room or is?
Oh, see, they're all true, aren't they?
Well, there's no smoke without fire, is there, Chris?
No. OK, all right.
And being a singer, I had to go to bed really early to preserve my voice.
Yeah. Go on.
You said in the footnotes to the... when you brought out the 4-CD Best Of, you sort of said, if I could get back with Jimmy again and write a song like In My Time of Dying,
yeah.
Do you think you've achieved that with this album, Driving to Clarksdale?
I think we're getting there.
Do you think?
Yeah, I think, we saw one take stuff working with Steve Albini. He's a serious engineer, and we...
Yeah, because you didn't want the producer, did you? You wanted somebody who was hands-on with Led Zeppelin.
Played, and it was, this is another interview. Do you know we've done 6,433 interviews? No, but you're absolutely spot on.
OK, listen, do you know how many internet sites you've got, fan internet sites?
Yeah.
26,292. That's how popular you still are, my friend.
Okay. And we can't get played on the radio because we're too old.
Well, I played you for 45 minutes this morning.
It
was thoroughly enjoyable. OK, get bothered by groupies much still, guys?
Only if we're lucky, yeah.
Oh,
Friday night. Friday, isn't it?
Friday night.
Friday night. Back up here, I think they'll all remember. I see him going to the match this day.